Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is meant by Goodman's criteria along with the Goodman's line. Now here we have a diagram which is also called as the diagram of Goodman or Goodman's criteria. Here Goodman's criteria, I'll write down Goodman's criteria, is used when ultimate stress is considered while designing. So when we are taking the ultimate stress into account, then we have to use the Goodman's criteria. Now Goodman's criteria, basically it consists of, it is a graph of variable stresses on y-axis, variable stresses versus mean stress. So it is a graph of variable stresses versus the mean stress. Now here, as we see, the line which is joining point capital A to capital B, it is called as the Goodman line or also called as failure stress line. At point A we have sigma E, which is called as endurance stress. At point B we have sigma U, called as ultimate stress. Joining them will give us the Goodman line, because ultimate stress is the maximum value, so this line won't cross sigma U, it will end only on sigma U. Similarly, it will end on sigma E. Next, what we are doing now, after this, dividing this sigma E by using factor of safety. So sigma E upon factor of safety, that will reduce the stress, because factor of safety is always greater than 1. So dividing sigma E by Fs, we are getting a stress value which is at point C. Similarly, sigma U value is greater, dividing sigma U by factor of safety, we get a point D. Now after getting point C and D, we will move parallel to AB and then join a line C to D, which is parallel to the Goodman line. Next, after this, we will take the midpoint of this line CD, point P, which is called as a design point, and on x-axis we would be getting mean stress and on y we would be getting variable stress. Now once we have understood this, next I can write down from this, the first thing is, from the similarity of triangles COD and PQD, from the similarities of triangles COD, this triangle, and PQD, the other triangle, we have PQ upon CO, that is the base of the triangle, PQ upon CO is equal to QD upon OD, that is the side of smaller triangle upon the side of the bigger triangle, QD upon OD. Next, QD, it can be written as, it is, QD can be written as, from OD we can subtract OQ, that will give us QD. So OD minus OQ upon OD will remain as it is. So therefore PQ upon CO is equal to OD upon OD minus OQ upon OD. So from this, OD and OD gets cancelled out, we have one here. So next we have PQ upon CO is equal to 1 minus OQ upon OD. Now after this we can say that PQ is nothing but variable stress sigma V. So instead of PQ, I can write down sigma V, variable stress. CO, as we can see, CO is sigma E upon factor of safety, sigma E, that is the endurance stress upon factor of safety, is equal to 1 minus, now OQ, OQ is equal to sigma M, and OD, OD is equal to sigma U upon FS, that is factor of safety. So sigma U upon factor of safety. Now once we have reached at this stage, I will keep sigma v on one side, that is therefore the variable stress. So now here I'll keep sigma v variable stress on one side, so therefore variable stress will be on one side, and I'll shift this term sigma e upon FOS onto the other side. So sigma e upon FOS, and here previously we have 1 minus sigma m upon sigma u divided by FOS. Now I'll simplify this. So we have sigma v is equal to sigma e upon FOS, I will keep it as it is. Next, this FOS will get multiplied above, so here this will be minus 1 minus sigma m into FOS upon sigma u, then this will be sigma u minus sigma m FOS upon sigma u, therefore sigma e upon sigma u upon sigma u, we can keep it one above the other, minus sigma m FOS upon sigma u. Next, sigma u will get cancelled out, so we have 1 which remains here, 1 minus sigma m into FOS upon sigma u. Now I will take FOS common or from the bracket, so we have sigma v is equal to sigma e upon FOS into FOS, I'll take it common, so inside the bracket we have 1 upon FOS minus sigma m upon sigma u. So FOS gets cancelled, so what remains here is therefore sigma v is equal to sigma e into 1 upon FOS minus sigma m upon sigma u. Now this equation, it can be simplified, so sigma v upon sigma e is equal to 1 upon FOS minus sigma m upon sigma u. Therefore, keeping 1 upon FOS on one side, bringing these terms onto the other side, so this term sigma m by sigma u, which is negative, will become positive. Now this is the equation of Goodman's criteria neglecting stress concentration. Now if in this the stress concentration is considered, then the equation, I can write it directly, it will modify to therefore 1 upon FOS is equal to sigma m upon sigma u plus sigma v into k suffix f divided by sigma e into surface into k size. So this is another equation of Goodman's considering the stress concentration factor. So this is equation of Goodman's criteria considering stress concentration. Here I'll explain the terms, where k suffix f, it is called as fatigue factor, and this is for stress concentration. Next we have k surface, it is called as the surface finish factor, and at last we have k suffix sz, which is called as size factor. So these factors are to be considered. Here we have Kf as the fatigue factor for stress concentration, Ksur which is the surface factor, Ksz which is the size factor. These factors are to be considered while designing any component, and previously the equation which I have written, it was neglecting all these factors. So in this video we have seen the Goodman's criteria along with the diagram, Goodman's line, and then the expression.